if you are taking return type, like you are taking int as return type of the function. So in this case, you have to return a value. Okay, so as you have taken integer as return type, so before you close the main, before you close the function, you need to return a value. Now, what type of value you will be returning? You will be returning one integer value. Return value can be 0, 1, usually minus 1, but that varieties of return is related to some context that as of now I'm not discussing. But what you asked is int is the return type of the main, so you need to return one value to main before you go out of main. As it is integer, so you are returning a value, that is what, 0. 0 is one integer, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
0 is one integer, so you are returning one integer from main. Now question is, where this return value is going? It is not going anywhere. It is returned to main only. It is returned to main function only, because there is no other function outside. Main is a single function. Okay, so as of now you understand, as int is the return type, so before you close you need to return a value, that is integer. You have taken the return type, so you must have to return one integer. Now one more thing we have discussed, that is if I don't give anything, so what will be the default type? Did anyone remembered?
Void.
Yes. Can anyone tell?
Ma'am, integer.
It will be by default integer. Very good. So even if I don't give any return type, by mistake also don't think it will be void, because nothing is there. So void comes to our mind first, but it is not. It will be integer. So in this case also you have to return one integer, and that will be 0. As of now you remember 0. Later on we will see what 1 does, what minus 1 does, okay, what all other thing does. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, when there will be two functions along with this main, when there will be another function, then it will be more clear that where the return value is going. But now, as of now, you have single function, so you are not getting the place, or you are not able to see where the return value is going. That is the main, that is the portion where I cannot make you clear as of now, until and unless we are starting with the function. Okay,
ma'am?
Now, yes.
Ma'am, when we write void main, so there is no required to write return 0 at the last?
No need to require, because what you are returning void. Void means what? Null. Null means what? You are not returning anything. Okay, so you will not give return 0. No return statement is required.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
That is interview question. So 3 questions: what is the meaning of void? What is the meaning of int main? What is the meaning of not writing integer as return type of main? Okay, so let us come to today's portion, and anytime you can ask question, so that if it is in my range, I will try to answer. Okay, so void and int main we have done. See, third topic. Okay, all of you are clear with ampersand mam did last days, printf and scanf. Okay, and I think identifier variable part. So ampersand part is completely clear for all of you, as it is a combined effort. So last days anything is there, like last 3 days anything is there which you need me to make clear, or I will start with the variable. And today's portion is this green color one. Okay, data type.
Ma'am, agadin program run kora hoy.
Yes,
agadin program ma'am run kora hoy ni.
Okay. So okay, let us run the program and let us see. Okay. So last day, I don't know which program. So let us take quickly one program. Okay, let me open this, that is better. So see, one thing while opening we will learn. For me, in all of you know about directory, right? In C directory I have a folder called turbo C. Okay, if you give C colon slash, then if you give the folder name where you have downloaded the C, that is turbo C 3 for me. It is not necessary that you have to give turbo C. Maybe 2-3 times I have installed and there was some problem. So these are the programs I have stored inside turbo C. Okay, clear? See, I am giving enter. What I got under turbo C, I have those folders. Folder inside folder, all of you are clear? Folder inside folder. Have you created folder inside folder? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. So in this project folder, I have those files. Okay. In this, I have created another folder for us, that is training one. Okay. In that folder, I have saved the program. Data type and addition. Okay, so you can see the addition program. Now I am not going for any introduction, directly we'll execute as you want to execute the program and see, and we'll brush up the concept once. So before scanf, I just want to tell you three integers we have taken, clear? A, B and C. Now I am not asking user to enter any number. I have given A, I have given B. Okay, so A and B will be added and the sum will be displayed. Okay, so 9 plus 5, 14 will be displayed. Okay, is the meaning of the program clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
All of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, we are getting one warning. Function should return a value. Why we are getting? Because int main we have given. So let us change it to void main. Okay. Okay. Now let us save what I told, that always save the program before you execute. And where it will be saved, my children? It will be saved to hard disk. Okay, for permanent storage. Now we have compiled, then we have run the program. Okay. Now you have run the program. As of now, I will not use. So 9 plus 5, 14, you can see as output. Now what we want to, all of you have seen the output?
Yes, ma'am.
So what we want to do is now, see this program, then we are fixed for two values until and unless we are changing it to some other value, but that should not be appreciated. So what should be appreciated is we will be taking the value from user. You are writing the program, I will be user and I will be giving the input. So now we have started with one more step, that is giving input to the program. Okay, so what will be my input now? This case, giving this 5 and 9, it should not be given to the program. It should be given after the execution of the program. The value of A and B will be given after the execution of the program. Did you understood what I told?
Yes,
all of you please unmute. Okay. So let me compile. I'll come for explanation just after a minute. So now what will happen? Enter two numbers. So suppose I want to give 4. Okay. I have pressed enter. So let me give the second value. Then cursor is blinking. I will give the enter. Okay. I have entered two values. Now let me check what is the value of sum coming. So this time, program is user friendly. I have given two numbers from my choice and computer has calculated the sum. Is it clear? Thus the input and output part is clear. How it is happening, I'm not asking. only input and output part is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
You got the difference between previous program and this program?
Yes.
Very good. Now, coming to the line. Scanf. Okay. What is the meaning of scanf? Scanf. Okay. Before that, you come to, okay, scanf only. Let us take. Scanf means what you know? When you want to take one number from user, at that time, you have to, you have a specific syntax. Let me write the syntax in front of you. S-C-A-N-F. Scanf is a function. What I told you that whenever there will be two brackets, that will be a function. Yes or no? Yes or no? Main is a function. So scanf also is a function. We all can understand. What is the syntax of scanf? Syntax of scanf means what is the correct way to write. Like how you write alphabet B after A. Similarly, A, P, P, L, E, U, right? I should give two double quote, one comma after that. In between double quote, what I should give? I will give percent D. What is percent D? Percent D is used to read the value of one integer. So what I'm going to read here, my children, I'm going to read the value of one integer variable. Is it clear? Is it clear? Yes. I'm going to read the value of one integer. Whose value I want to read? A's value I want to read. Okay. So this much I have done. Is it clear? Percent D. D is for integer. No reason for that. When C compiler is designed, it is written, scanf function is written in such a way that you have to pass these two values. Two values in the sense percent D. For integer, so A is integer, so you have given 1% D. Similarly, if you want to read, if you want to read two integers, what you will do? You will give second percent D. And which you want to read, that should, you should give by comma. After this quotation also, comma is compulsory. And if you want to read two things, two comma you should give. Now, I have not yet given ampersand, I will give. 3 if you want to do, what you will do? Like that 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, you can give continuously. No comma is required. Left side portion of scanf within double quote is clear for all of us?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt is there from anyone? Okay. So now, please tell me, because I'm not, cannot see your eyes, I can't understand your understanding. So I have to give the ampersand sign. Why I have to give ampersand sign? See, now these both are equivalent. You want to read A, you want to read B. Only one thing is not clear, that is why ampersand is given. So scanf, whatever was there previously, that only let us skip. Step by step we wrote. So this one. Now let me go back to the memory. Last day, do you remember? Last day means just in your second class. What I told you is, this is our memory. Okay. In this memory, what you did, you want to, when you have declared int, I'm writing, can you all see? Int A comma B. What happened? When you have declared int A comma B, what happened? For A, one memory is allocated. Let me call this as A. This is for A. When it happened, when I wrote int A comma B, for A one memory is allocated, and for B also one memory is, This is B. Now two questions may come to your mind, that ma'am, you have written somewhere as A. Somewhere you wrote A? Yes, it is somewhere. It more possibility is there, you know, it will be allotted here for A. Why? Because these two space already some variable is occupying. Okay. So whichever is the first free space available in a memory, that will be allocated for your first allocated variable. Which is your first allocated variable? A. So A will be occupying this memory space actually. A will be taking this memory space actually. If I don't take A here, no problem, because let us make it completely clear. So this is A, which is the second space available. This one is the second space. So this one will be occupied by B. So this will be your B. This much did we all understood? This is for A, this is for B, because this is the first memory available. Suppose in a hostel, there are many rooms. Room 1 and 2 was allocated. This room and this room was allocated. Now first allocated room, your warden will allocate for you. Fourth room is allotted. So second student comes means fifth room will be given. Is that clear for everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, for memory, all the rooms are having one address. Like in your college, you will be having numbers for room. So first room is 0th room, second room is 1 room. So where A is allocated, that room number I'm writing on the top. So that is room number 2. And this one, which we have given as green, that room number is 01, this is 2, sorry. This one is 3rd room and this one is 4th room. So what address A got? A got a address location which is nothing but 2. And B got a address location which is nothing but equals to 4. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now one more complication is there. What is that complication, you know? Integer always takes 2 bytes of memory. Integer always take 2 bytes of memory. In memory, these all locations are 1 byte. So this room will not be allotted for A. Why it will not be allotted for A? Because I don't have this memory available. I'm assuming this memory is available. So now I can allot 2 and 3, 2 memory for A. Is this clear? Why? Because integer always require 2 bytes of memory. So I'm assuming, as I have already given the address, so I'm assuming these 2 memories were free before only. Location 2 and 3. So now for A, this location can be allocated. Is this clear? Any integer requires 2 consecutive, 2 together memory, because 2 bytes, that 2 bytes cannot be 1 here, 1 there. Okay, if you need 2 room for you, obviously you will not take 1 room in the first floor and 1 room in the down. You should be going for 2 consecutive, 2 continuous rooms. Yes or no, my children?
Yes, ma'am.
And in this case, so it is fixed. You can compromise, but there is no compromise because number will not be broken and stored in the 2 places. So wherever 2 bytes of memory will be available, there will be allocation for A. Similarly, so you can think these 2 memory will be occupied by A. I'm changing the color because your mind something else will be there. So A, for A it is allocated. Now for B also similarly, B is also integer. So for B also 2 rooms will be allocated. Now is this confusion coming to our mind that 2 and 3 both the rooms are occupied by A? Then why the address of A is 2? Why the address of A is 2? Because this is the starting address. Always we will call the starting address. Take a simple example. In your address, suppose in your locality, you stay in a house number 32. But in that house number, you have 3-4 rooms. All will be having address 32 only. Whether you have 2 rooms or whether you have 10 rooms, your address will be 32 only. Yes or no? Is it clear for all my children? Everyone, it is clear? Yes? Okay. So now, no confusion in that. 2 and 4 memory is allotted for A and B. Now, when you are reading it, ampersand A means address of A. What is address of A? Address of A is 2. Is it clear? For all of you, ampersand means address. So ampersand A means address of A. So address of A is what? 2. Now come back to the program. What we are doing here is, in address of A, we are taking the first value. In address of A means the location which is allotted for A, that is location 2, memory location 2. In that, you remember I have given which value? 4 and 6. So where the 4 will go? 4 will go to this memory location. Similarly, I have given where I have scanned the addressed location B. This I will tell you again and again every day. As of now, you make it clear, every day I will be telling you, so that it should reside in your mind. Address of B is 4. So when you are giving a value 6, you are scanning, right? While scanning, you are writing ampersand B. It means what? Address of B you are scanning. It means what? Whatever value you are giving, that is 6, that is going to address of B. Address of B is what? Address of B is 4. Address of B is 4. So in the address location 4, the value 6 is going. Let us take quickly one example. You are asking your friend to go to your home. So what you will give? You will give home address. Okay. So similarly, you have also given the home address of A, home address of B, and whatever person is coming, 4 and 6, they are going to that address location. So 4 and 6 are stored in the memory location 2 and 4. How they have stored? They have converted to binary and they have stored in that location. A location 4 means what? If it is 101, so as I told you, 16 bit total 16 bit, so 3 bits value I have, remaining 13 bit will be 0. 2 memory location means 8 plus 8 bit 16 bit. In that, 13 bit will be 0 and 3 bits will be 101, whatever is the value binary converted to that value. Binary conversion as of now, no. You just understand it is converted to binary. Is this much clear for all of us? Any doubt is there? This is another question for your interview. Basic question, that is, what does ampersand mean? Draw a memory map and show. Draw a memory map and show. All of us know that is ampersand. That is no need to understand. Ampersand means with scanf, I have to give ampersand. I have given, it is done. No. You have to make them understand that you have understood the fact. Okay. So this is not today's portion. I think so much time is going for previous day's portion. Is it clear? Printf is clear for all of you. We have executed. So sum is an integer. So coming back to sum. Sometimes it happens. Coming back to sum. So where is the sum memory will be allocated? Sum is also an integer. So which memory will be allotted for sum? Can you tell me? Which memory location will be allotted for sum? I have declared one more variable. That is sum. So 6 and 7 will be occupied. 4 and 5 will be occupied by B. So next location is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Very true. So memory location 7, this is your memory location 7. Okay, it will not be written inside. Okay, it will not be written anywhere. Compiler will recognize it. For our under, A will not be written anywhere. 7 also will not be written anywhere. Okay, that is all our compiler's understanding. Like in your room, do you write room number inside your room? This is drawing room, so number 1, drawing, dining room number 2, no. Similarly, compiler can understand where it is. Okay, so 7 is not written anywhere. But for our understanding, it happens like that. This understanding comes to compiler's mind when compiler does the execution.
Ma'am.
So, yes.
Ma'am, are these values fixed?
Yes.
Means I'm not understanding. Are these values fixed in that the memory bar that you have wrote? table 0146.
Which one you are telling?
Ma'am, in the table that you wrote, that 0, 1, 4, then blank, then 6, then blank.
No. This is not 0, 4. Suppose these two rooms are already occupied by some variable. These two are already occupied by some number. Let's say previously 33 was stored here. 55, 500 something was stored here. So these two rooms are not free. Is that much understandable? Yellow colored rooms are already occupied. So where is the first free location? This one, this blue is the first free location. Yes or no?
Yes.
I have already given color. Previously it was empty. So for A, this room was allocated. Is that much clear? And yes, A takes 2 bytes of memory. 2 bytes of memory. So 2 and 3, room number 2 and 3, both are occupied by B. Room number 2 and 3, because integer means 2 bytes of memory will be required. Is that much clear, dear?
Yes, ma'am.
Next is B. Again, these two rooms were free. So these two rooms, what is the address? 4. So starting from 4, 4 and 5, two rooms were given to B. Now sum. So for sum, location 7 is there and location 8 is there. That 2 should be given. Yes?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
I am not writing location inside the room. Location I am writing outside. So 2 and 3, I wrote outside the room. But value I wrote inside the room. Because what value you have given for A? Value you have given for A is 4. What value you have given for B? That is 6. That is stored in room number 4. Memory location 4. It is not table. It is your memory. Okay. So this is the value. Value is stored here. 6 is stored in the memory location 4. And 4 is stored in the memory location 2. If it is clear, please tell me. Otherwise,
yes,
I will
ma'am, understood. No, ma'am, understood.
Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Understood. Very good. Very good. See, you can once see. First number, what I gave 4. Second number, what I gave 6. Okay. So, 4 is stored in memory location 2 and 6 is stored in B is starting from where? B is starting from memory location 4. Okay. Now, for sum, which two memory will be allocated? These two memory will be allocated. These two next two. Okay. So for sum, these two memory will be allocated. I'm just changing the color minutely so that you can understand. Okay. So this is for sum. So which are these two memory? This is memory number 7 and 8. Now, when the processing is done by CPU, how I am not concentrating? 4 plus 6 is added. 4 is stored in A and 6 is stored in B. 4 plus 6 is added. Now, after adding 4 plus 6, 10 is generated. Where 10 will be stored? 10 will be stored in the memory location sum. Means memory location 7. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it completely clear for all of you? Is there any doubt?
Ma'am, beside this 10, it is empty.
It is not empty. 10 will be occupying these two locations. That's what I told. Two locations means how it will be occupying? 0000000. 8 bits of 0. Then 10, suppose converted 10 is 1011. So 0000, then 1011. That's how it should be. 8 zeros, then again 4 zeros, then binary of 10. Like that, these two rooms will be there. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am, it is clear.
Converted 10 is 4 bits, suppose. You have to fill 16 bits. So remaining 12 bit from the left side, 12 bit will be 0. Then converted to binary, whatever value 10 will have, that will be there. Okay. Whole will be occupied. No one can occupy this because 10 is taking less space. So some other program will occupy that. No, it is reserved completely. You have paid for the room. Some has paid for the room. So nobody can take it, even though it is zero. Is it clear? Okay. What do you mean by data type? Can you tell me? Okay, let me tell, time is less. Data type means all data is having a type. What can be the type of the data? Your type of the data can be integer, can be floating point, can be character. Okay, let us open this program. Yes. 1 minute. We have three types of data type. Okay. Basic data type. There are many. I will discuss slowly. Integer, I have taken one. Character, I have taken one. Let me not take more. Let me tell first. Integer is the data type for A. So what does it mean telling integer A? What does it mean? It means you are telling A should occupy 2 bytes of memory space. And it cannot consist of any decimal point, cannot consist of any characters. Is the meaning of integer clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Let me show you quickly. Let me show you quickly one small thing. Okay, identifier, that verification, I think. Not taken. 1 second. Okay, you can see as of now from here. Integer, it takes 2 bytes or 4 bytes. Can you see this? Integer, it takes 2 bytes or
yes,
4 bytes of memory. Let me open this. Here my photo to copy. 1 second. Okay. Integer takes 2 bytes or 4 bytes. I told you should not bother about it. As of now, we are discussing integer takes 2 bytes. It depends on system architecture. It depends on the Turbo C compiler also, which I was also not knowing before. I used to know it is dependent on compiler. But no, I have 64-bit system, so integer would have taken 4 bytes. But because of the compiler, it is taking 2 bytes. I will show you how it is 2 bytes in next other class. Now, it means what? 2 bytes means what? What maximum value I can accommodate? I can accommodate 32,768 minus 32,768 to 32,767 for 2 bytes. Did you understood what I told? 34,667. If you convert to binary, it will be 1111111. So for 2 bytes, what is the maximum value? Tell me. 1111111. That is the maximum value. Are we all able to understand what I'm telling?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that value, minimum value is all 16 zeros, maximum value is all 16 ones. So that should be corresponding to one integer number. Integer number means normal number, which does not have any decimal point. So which is that number? That is 32,767. Now the question is, if you give some number like 32,769, what will happen? We cannot accommodate it in the integer. We cannot accommodate it in the integer. There will be overflow. So for that case, I need a long type of integer. So if I cannot accommodate some value which is more than 32,767, to accommodate that number, I should go for the bigger type of integer, which is called long. As of now, long is not needed. You understand the integer completely. So, did all my children understood the meaning of integer? Only concentrate on integer. So, I'm omitting all the other lines to make the integer clear. Sorry. I'll come to next line. Character, I won't tell now. Float also, I won't tell now. I will tell. I have given a value. Let us, do this negative conversion anyhow, we are not doing. So anyhow, as of now, you understand what is the meaning of integer. Integer means you understood 2, 3, 4, 5, everything. What is the range? 32,767. Okay, so as of now, I should not go for taking all those things. I will go for taking only one, that is A. And I will come back to the printf syntax also. See, as we, in the time of printing, in the time of scanning, we gave %d. So similarly, I can give %d in the, I must have to give %d for printing one integer. Is this clear? I am giving sum colon. Why I am giving sum colon? Because whatever will be there in the inverted comma, that will be printed as it is, as we have seen before. If I write high %d, what is the meaning? In the time of printing, the value of A, high will be printed before. If I give A equals 2, so I can see on the screen A equals 2 got printed as it is. %d will never be printed. %d is what it is called, format specifier. Okay. If I have %d written here, after quotation, after comma, I have to give one variable name which is integer, which is declared as integer. Okay. And I must be having the value for the integer. I have given A value as 32,767. And here I want to print A. So what we learned, this is called format specifier. %d is called format specifier. I'm not giving any ampersand. Why I'm not giving any ampersand? Your friend is going to your house. So when he is entering his house to your house, he is coming. So you are giving address of your house, what you did in the scanf. But when he is going out, like it is coming for display, you don't need to give any ampersand sign. So for printf, no ampersand is required. Whatever value is there in the location A, that value will be printed. Can you please check this, whether the meaning of this program is understandable or not? We have taken one integer, given the value of the integer, and we are printing the value of A. We have not scanned. You would have scanned. Let me scan. Scanf. Scanf. I want to scan. Okay. So what I should do? I will write %d. Now I will write ampersand A. I missed to give comma. I will give comma. So this line I don't need to do. Is it clear for all of you? Giving scanf or directly giving value, what is the difference? Sorry,
yes, ampersand.
Ampersand. So let me run the program. Let me run the program. Okay, I'm compiling. Okay, so you are scanning one number. So let me give 3333 and let me check the output. Next day I will remove the output. So can you see the number, how much big it has become now? It is more than 32,000. So what value I am giving for A? I am getting some other negative value. Why? Because it is not in the range of integer. Did you understood what happened? It is giving me some junk value because it could not able to store this value 33333. Okay, it could not able to store this much of value. Did you understood what happened here?
Yes, ma'am.
Let me compile it once again for clear understanding. Let me run this. Let us run this. I'm giving the value 777. Okay. Now let me check the output. I am getting 777, my dear children. I am getting, yes or no?
Yes.
Now if I go beyond the range, if I go beyond the range, let me compile once again. Let me run it. Let us run the program. If we run the program and give 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, some big number, if we give, what will get? Tell me. We are getting some negative number. Always will get negative? No. nothing like that. You can get anything which is not actual value. Why you are getting this? Because from that 8888 something, some portion is stored, so something is converted that we don't know what compiler understood and did, because it is overflow. It is not able to store, we cannot able to store this in the range of integer. So we could not able to store. So up to this range, we can able to store the value. We are scanning one variable and we are printing that. Scanning means what? We have opened one memory in the memory location. Int A means what? One memory is allocated in the memory location. Yes, understandable. So one address is already allocated. Who is allocating? Are we allocating? No. Compiler is allocating any random location in the memory. Suppose that location address is 100. So when you are scanning ampersand A, means whatever value I'm giving, scanf means what? I'm compiling and I'm giving one value. So now compiler is asking me to enter some value. I'm giving 44. So I have given some value. Where it has gone? In the location 100, what is reserved for A? I don't know what is that location. Some location is reserved. There it has gone. Now I am printing this. Okay. So what will be the output? Whatever value I gave, 44 previous value you neglect. What was there? 44 I have given. So I am getting 44 only. Did you understood?
Yes.
If no, please tell me. Let me give one backslash in one second. Daily same thing I will tell when the program will increase also. Okay. Let me give the value here. 55. Okay, in the next line, 55 it is coming. Is hanged somehow hanged, maybe because I have when I gave 44 it was printing, but when I gave some other thing, like not in this range, what range I showed you, not in this range I have showed you, do you able to recall? Because no time to start, one second. So if I give in the range 32,667, so in that range, if I have given, it was printing. But when I gave 3333333333 something big number, it was not able to print because it is not in the range of integer. Did you understood?
That's right.
You have sixteen chairs. 16 chairs are allocated for one integer. So if you have 17th person, what will happen? 16 will sit, 1 will come out, but if I make a rule, no, it is not possible only, because whether either all should sit or no one will sit. So what will happen? All will somehow come out, all will think no, 1 will sit, 2 will come out. I cannot make out that whether 16 will sit and only 1 will come out. That will not happen here, because 16 bits are allocated, so
the output will be notified.
Notified in the sense you will get something else when you will give beyond this range. When you will give a value for integer beyond this range, 32,767, beyond that range, if you give 67, 69, what will happen? It will be notified in the sense you have given one number and some other number is getting displayed. Why? Because you have to know that there is a limit for integer. If it exceeded, and then some junk value will be printed. Junk means some wrong value will be printed. Okay, it is important for us to know the range of the integer, that is 32,767. More than that we cannot store. So the question is whether we'll not be able to store any larger number. Obviously, in that case, instead of integer, you have to declare A as long A, you have declared int A, you have to declare it as long A.